sports, let me find out. My team ballin', you look like you need a timeout. I'm a star, in the clutch, I'ma shine out. Working hard, yeah, I'm back on my grind now. Game on, took a loss, but I stay strong. Super Bowl rings, I just wanna play off. Gotta go hard, I can never play soft. Giant in New York, I run it back like Saquon. And I gotta win no matter what, like fourth down, Hail Mary, no punch, like every time I touch that.
Thank you, Coach. Soldier Field opened back in 1924 with the Bears becoming tenants in 71. And what a home field advantage it has become here in Chicago. Nothing like the fanfare of introductions to an NFL game, and that was in evidence a moment ago. Fireworks, pyrotechnics, you name it, this crowd is ready as their guys get set to match up between the New Orleans Saints and the Chicago Bears. Getting toward the halfway point of the NFL season, Week 7 is underway on EA Sports. This is taken about 7 yards deep. Oh, able to avoid him. And he'll take it up past the 25 to the 26-yard line. At their own 26-yard line. They will run for the first time with David Montgomery. Only a couple there as he'll be brought down about the 28. Only a couple for him there on the game's first play, and it's second down.
They tried a quick hitter inside, but that one was swallowed up because what they're hoping, this big defensive lineman will take the bait and move laterally and open up a crease that they can run through. Didn't happen on that play.
And that is incomplete. A lot of force bearing down on him there. He could not hang on. It's third down.
But he kind of forced that one there, didn't he? It's almost like he predetermined where he was going to go with the football.
Yeah, he wasn't really going through progressions. He wanted to go to his top guy. You do that against this defense, they'll make you pay, won't they?
Yeah, they certainly will. They react very quickly to the thrown football.
Throwing is Mahomes on third. This one into the hands of Burton. And he'll be brought down with the first down and a late flag here, too. And he may get a few more tacked on for good measure. So that flag will cost him 15.
And it doesn't matter anymore how you get the face mask. Any part of it, that's going to be 15 yards.
And now it's first and 10, a big mistake, especially when you factor in the personal foul yardage. Following the penalty, Montgomery. DeMario Davis there on the stop.
Well, we saw him there trying to get it to the outside, trying to get to the perimeter, but not a whole lot of room there. But there's got to be one positive to that. If you keep moving laterally, creases tend to develop as the game moves on, and they can run it back inside later.
On second and 9, Mahomes. And that going to be incomplete. A lot of contact, no call, and it's third down.
You get a tight end like this, and you know he's used to dishing out punishment, but here, he's the one that has to absorb the contact, and as a result, unable to hold on to the football.
And they'll need to get to the 35 if they want to keep this drive going on third down. From the gun, it's Mahomes. He may try and run for this. And this is going to be another first down as the tackle's made at the Saints 33.
We just saw a nice example of why teams often bring in baseball guys to teach quarterbacks how to slide in key situations. You want to protect your franchise guy. Make sure he doesn't get hurt. He did exactly that on that play. A perfect slide to avoid the big hit and pick up a first down.
Watch out, watch out, watch out, watch out. Hey, watch it.
Mahomes now on first down. Nowhere to escape, and he goes down. Lightning speed that time from the corner. Marshawn Lattimore getting the sack. And they need to work to at least get some of this yardage back after the sack. Second and 19. Throwing now is Mahomes. And the hookup here to Allen Robinson. And he is out of bounds, but not before he's inside the 30. It'll be a pickup of 15 as that'll lead to third down. Here comes the seventh play of this opening drive. They've moved it well, but here's third down.
Check 52, check 31. 15, 15. Right side, right side.
Working from the gun, Mahomes. And this is caught by Watkins. And he takes this one in for a Bears touchdown. Sammy Watkins, his sixth touchdown of the season, as his guys are able to strike first here in this opening quarter. Extra point splits the uprights, and it's now a 7-0 game. Set now to kick this one away, and off it goes. This fielded a few yards into the end zone. And he'll be brought down at the 23, make it the 24-yard line. Complete. A Saints first down there on a gain of 11. Now, Charles, what's the mindset here offensively? You gave up the touchdown pretty quickly. Would it have changed if you'd gotten a stop and it would be 0-0 right now or no?
I wouldn't think so. I think in most cases, just down a touchdown, you know, I mean, we're just getting started here. It should be a long way to go. You think to yourself, stick with the game plan, all the things you worked on in practice. But you have some teams that when they get down, their natural tendency is to aggressively strike back. And let's see if they want to get outside of the game plan we expect and try and be aggressive on their first series.
They'll run out of the gun with Kamara. They follow up the first down 1 yard run with a minimal gain of 2.
Recon, 132 fighter.
Third down, Herbert. This time for Smith, and it's intercepted. Picked off at the 40, and he's able to get it back here to the 43-yard line. Defensively that time, they were in zone coverage. As a rookie QB, what lesson can you learn there?
Well, understand this. You saw zone in college, and the defensive backs reacted, but they don't react like they do on this level. So when they're in zone and they see the ball coming to them, they'll react at least a half a second faster. You've got to know where you want to go with the ball and be decisive with it. Otherwise, the end result can be something you don't like.
And this one goes nowhere. Losing yardage on the play back at the 46.
I like the strategy. Extra tight ends, extra beef. They want to run the football, but that means they probably want to run it inside. If you get strung out on the perimeter, you're in peril.
Yeah, we saw the result. Negative yardage. On the carry, it's Montgomery. It's a 7-yard pickup. They'll be looking now to 3rd and 6.
But you got to give kudos to your offensive line and the guy carrying the ball, because they were in a 2nd and long situation. It seemed pretty dire, but they brought it back to 3rd and manageable with that run.
And this will probably be the last play of the quarter. After 1-7-0 on EA Sports.
All right, nice. Hey, 43, 43, 15.
Watch his flat, watch his flat. Watch his flat, watch his flat.
Yellow.
Check 99.
Hey, yellow, hey, go going.
Switch. Check. Go.
Okay.
From the gun on third down, Mahomes is going to fire one deep, middle of the field. And that will be incomplete. Well, they weren't scared to let it fly, but it falls to the ground and brings up fourth down.
You hear the calls for a penalty, but I just don't think so. I think in this situation, the defender was making sure his guy couldn't hold on to the football. So I don't see anything that warranted a flag.
No, I'm with you. There was contact, but I'm happy they kept that flag in the back pocket. They got the interception, but very little movement after, and that forces him to settle for three. And it does feel like settling when that happens, doesn't it?
It certainly does, but we got to give a lot of credit where it's due, and that's to the defense because they ran onto the field. It's what we call sudden change, right? Interception, you got to go put out the fire, and they did, holding them to a field goal.
The Saints offense on the field, ready to get their drive started. Nothing for them yet from an offensive standpoint. Down 10-0 as they come up first and 10. A nice run on first down gets him 6 yards to the 31. It's a 6-yard pickup, but it gets him to second and 4.
Let's talk a little football 101 here, because one of the keys to advancing the ball downfield, success on first down. Huge difference, as we know, between second and 4 and second and 8 and 9.
The last run got 6. Now second and 4.
Out. Bristol, travel. Let's go. Let's bring it. Let's bring it. High 7. 5.
Second and 4. He's got his all-pro receiver, Michael Thomas. And he gets this up across the 35 before he's out of bounds. 6 yards the pickup, and that's a first down. Line of scrimmage, the 37 on first and 10. Looking to throw. Herbert, it's Hill, complete. Give him a couple on the catch at second and 8.
And partner, I think that's a great example that not all tight ends are created equal, because everything was right. Got the completion, but he's not one of the more dynamic guys in the league. So even though he caught it, couldn't turn it into much more.
Kamara tried to right side. And there is nowhere for him to cut back as he's taken down in the backfield. The tally there, minus 2 yards, brings up third down. Two minutes gone by, second quarter. To throw on third down, Herbert. Open man is Michael Thomas. And he's going to have another first down as the tackle's made here at the Bears 37. The last drive, he threw the pick, but he's not shy. He's going downfield again there.
And you can't be, because if you back off after throwing an interception, your whole game plan just goes right out the window, and it makes things easier for a defense. And you and I both know there isn't a quarterback in this league that's any good that doesn't throw an interception occasionally, and they usually bounce back in a big way. I've seen guys throw 5 and still find a way to win the game in the end.
Call it a full 3 yards in the wrong direction there. Brings up second down.
Let's go now. 18 Gator. 6-6.
To throw on second down, Herbert. Nowhere to escape, and he goes down. Bilal Nichols, he's the one that got home and takes him down for a loss of 9. They don't need to run another play here before the 2-minute warning. Let's see if they do it anyway.
Nice, team 6, team 6. Go.
Throwing on third and long. Herbert steps away to his left. Oh, bottled up. Fumble. It's out. It's loose. And I think the Bears have recovered. They have. A reminder coming up just a few minutes from now. We'll send you to Jonathan Coachman and our crew in Orlando. Coach will have a look back at some of the stats and scores from yesterday's action. Y- Given 30 yards there.
It's not a surprise when you read scouting reports and watch tape because you know he's a heck of a player. But he is so difficult to get down in the open field. They just want to get him the ball and let him do his thing.
If there was one area that the coach emphasized in our pregame meeting, it was red zone offense.
In a sense, I got from it, and I think you did as well. They weren't real happy with how they were executing previously, so they put a lot of time and effort into it because getting points is paramount. Doesn't matter what you do otherwise, don't leave the red zone without putting points on the board.
So they had the big loss on that first down pass play and facing a second and long.
Hey, Ripley, Ripley.
Quick throw here caught by Gabriel. And he's going to lose yardage and be backed up to the 25. It'll be a loss of a yard, and they're going to face an uphill battle here on third and long.
Yellow.
Here we go, D. No.
Hey, 57 color, 57 color.
Motion. Check.
Hey, Sunday. Shifting yellow.
SOS.
Alpha.
SOS.
Check. Right.
Here's Mahomes to throw. He finds Robinson. They're able to convert on third down, and that sets up a first and goal.
It's a game of matchups, and that's why you take your receivers and move them around a bunch, especially your best guys. And when they work out of the slot, you often hear the coaches talk about how great it is because it gives you a two-way go. You can break out or you can break in. That makes it hard to defend.
Mahomes to throw once more. Got his man, and it's caught for a Chicago touchdown. Taylor Gabriel, his sixth touchdown of the season as the Bears push further out in front. Point after try forthcoming. He's got it, and it's 17-0. The kickoff team on the field now as they will send this one away. And a fair catch signaled for and taken successfully.
Let's go.
The Saints take over first and 10 at their own 25-yard line.
The Saints offense on the field ready to get their drive started. You've got less than 30 seconds left here in the half. You're well on your own side of the field. What are we doing here, Coach Davis?
Well, I'm trying something on first down. And it's something that's safe. It's something that's been done many times before.
Well, this is taken in. It's complete. The Saints going to call the first of their timeouts as the clock will stop with 21 seconds to go here in the first half. This offense finding its legs now. Here's another first and 10.
Undercross, X3, 218, chopper, leave driven.
Stepping up, he's going to keep it. 2 yards the gain on the keeper, and it's second down. Now we'll get a quick timeout called by New Orleans, number 2. As they'll stop it with 17 seconds to go in this first half of action. Looking to throw on second down. Herbert. He's got it. Hit the 15. Give him 32 on the play. So how about this for field position after the big play? Inside the 15 now as they come up on first and 10.
Rock it. Ready?
From the red zone now, they'll look to throw. And he'll take it into the end zone for the Saints touchdown. Traquan Smith in the final seconds of the first half as they are now on the board here in the first half. Lutz good on the extra point, and that'll cut the lead to 17-7. Morstead out now following the touchdown to kick. And no return on this one as the fair catch is signaled for and taken.
The Bears take over first and 10 at their own 25-yard line.
At the line, prepping for their next drive, the Bears offense. Time for a final kneel down or a safe run, and then they can head to the locker room with a lead.
Yeah, or they can even run a screen. You know, something that feels somewhat safe that might actually pop and turn into a big play. That's what you usually run in this situation.
Or go four verticals, because why not?
Because you're feeling it, right? You're just feeling it.
All right, Coach, thank you, and we welcome everyone back for quarter number three. Both teams appear ready for the fight ahead, and we resume action here in quarter number three. This is Fielded a couple yards deep. And he'll get this just up past the 20, but a marker is down. Let's get the call. This is going to put him back with a not great field position.
So they really got zero benefit at all, right? Sometimes you can absorb a penalty when you get a big return. Then the penalty brings it back, but you still have great field position. As you pointed out, not in this case.
Throwing on first down, Herbert. And the throw left sideline here is caught, but they'll rule it incomplete. Couldn't keep his feet in. Second down. You know, despite the scoreline, I think they've got to like where they are here. They're on the road and just one big play away from getting right back in this game.
I'm going to follow right along with you, because the spot they're in now is a credit to their defense. They've kept them in it by making the plays that they've made, and that just means you're one big score away from being right back there.
Now the question is, can this offense step up and make that play? Because that's been an issue for them in this game. Oh, he got position on him, and he pulls it in. 22 yards there, a first down.
I know many people like to throw to the tight end, maybe in a little flexed out position, because he creates mismatches with his size. But slot receivers do the same thing with their quickness, their speed, and their route running savvy.
On first and 10, Herbert. And oh, he took that in one-handed. What a grab. That's back-to-back plays of over 20 yards.
Gotta love the catch. I think you gotta love the gloves as well.
Yeah, these one-handed catches, that was great, and they're fun. They're becoming a little more ho-hum, aren't they?
Yeah, they really are, and I know that it sounds like we're taking credit away from the guys, and we don't mean that at all. They really work hard on this one-handed catch thing. I think the gloves have to be helping in a big way.
It's caught at the 10. Touchdown, New Orleans. A big play there. His second touchdown on the season, as they are now just an extra point away from making this a three-point game. Lutz with the extra point, and the lead's down to a field goal at 17-14. Morstead out now following the touchdown to kick. That'll be taken in the end zone. Now a hit and a loose football. And this is picked up by the Saints. And a terrific return as he takes this thing all the way down near the 20-yard line. So a teammate picking him up there, that was nearly disaster.
And the way that you coach these things, you want to make sure you have eyes towards the return guy, because you want to make sure that the catch is secured. A lot of teams do that. They have at least one guy. Okay, you're responsible for making sure he secures the catch. He's not always the one that makes the recovery, but he can always sound out the alarm. Hey, ball's on the ground. We've got to get it back.
Get ready. 10 over. Bring it. Hey, Wahoo. Hey, Jet. Yeah.
On first down, Herbert. Buying time to his left. And incomplete, he dropped it in the end zone. We have not seen a whole lot of wide open receivers. Everything seemingly has been contested.
And that's another nice job there to force an incompletion. They've been very cohesive, knowing each other's moves all game long. And they've been on the spot just about every time.
And they've held them in check on the scoreboard. Big play coming up. Here's third and 10.
I would expect to see some pressure here.
Yeah. Five. Five.
I've got Mike 10 right here, guys. Mike 10. Check.
And the blitz does come. Under pressure, and he'll go down. Sacked back at the 31. The inside linebacker, Danny Trevathan, gets the sack.
Now, that was just absolute perfect man coverage. Nowhere for them to go with the football led to a sack. That's really difficult to do in today's NFL with all these gazelles running around that you're trying to cover in the secondary.
17-17 the score. All even to this point as the kick's away. The Bears offense ready to go for their next drive. First half showed us some pretty good offense. Tie game, we'll see what the second half brings.
And it'll be interesting because I think both sides feel pretty good about what their offenses are doing. Gotta wonder what adjustments are being made defensively to try and get a spark and maybe slow down the other side.
But here, do you change up anything on this opening drive?
Not offensively, you don't. You've got everything going your way. You've probably prepared for maybe some change-ups you might expect, but overall, you like what your game plan showing you.
Now Mahomes on the bootleg. Steps away. Now he'll pull it down. He'll end up getting five out of that, but now they're looking at third down.
The best quarterbacks that ever played the game all wanted to blend in with their teammates and be one of the guys. But sometimes you got to take modesty and put it aside. You're the franchise quarterback, the face of the team, and the guy that leads them to victory. You have to get down and protect yourself and not take hits like that.
Now a shot taken on third down, but it's going to wind up incomplete.
But it's not been the best game for him. But he definitely tried to get by with a little help from his friend there, trying to create a big play.
Couldn't do it, fell incomplete. But you're right, hasn't been a banner game here in the second half, just trying to get going.
Big thing is trying to keep confidence up and continue to fire.
The Saints offense on the field, ready to get their drive started. And after the field goal last time, we'll see what they can get here. And at least they got points out of the last drive, Charles.
I never met an offensive coach that didn't want a drive to end with a kick. Most of them want it to end with a PAT, right? In this case, a field goal, they'll take it. Way better than the alternative, which is a punt.
Yeah, but you met fan bases that wanted that. They weren't happy with that field goal.
I've met
pressure, and he's taken down. A bear sack. Bilal Nichols, his second sack of the night.
And that's his second sack of the game, but this player, disruptive in all phases, whether he's going upfield, coming underneath, you name it. He's a big-time guy you have to block.
Back to throw. Herbert. Out of the backfield. That's complete to Kamara. And they'll bring him down here up at about the 22-yard line. It'll be a pickup of 15 as that'll lead to third down.
And a nice gain and a broken tackle along the way. And really, we shouldn't be surprised, should we? That's what runners do, especially the best ones. They break tackles and gain extra yardage.
Look at me, Zipper! Topper, Topper! Hey, high seven! Hard!
Two! On third and two, Herbert. And he's got his man on the out route. They're able to convert with a gain of four.
So how would you describe that one, partner? Workmanlike right there, getting that first down, blue-collar type football?
Yeah, only needed three, got four.
Hey, bro, I don't know what you doing with the game, bro. But this shit getting ridiculous, bro. For real, dog.
Perfect since the second half started. 7 of 7.
Hey, man, come on, bro. These are some bullshit catches you getting, bro. All these shit's animated. Come on, man. Jesus Christ, it's some bullshit. But I missed the pass right in the middle.
Come on. We'll return with more after this. This is the NFL, and it's on EA Sports.
You should have. Hell, you gotta wait on me. I was fucked up.
A pretty good game all weekend. We may have saved the best for last. This Monday night game has been a dandy.
That was all types of fucked up. That shit crazy, bro. They giving you some shit. I had a pick on the wheel route. Like, come on, bro. Like, hey, they can't keep doing this to me. Look at that shit.
14 yards is the pickup. First down.
Hey, man, they can't keep doing this to me, bro. That's all I know, bro. That's all I know, bro. A lot of people would call it a gutsy type of a throw. Something got to give sooner than later, bro. You throw some tight-ass passes, bro. That's all I'm going to say, bro.
13 of 16 throwing the football.
Something got to give soon. We work.
This is complete to Michael Thomas.
That's for real. I got respect for it.
39 yards the distance covered on the catch and run. I know
we love our jobs. That was a pick, too. That's what I'm saying. Like, bro, I don't understand, bro. Come on, bro. No way, like, this nigga just super glid in front of me like that, bro.
The fist pump from the sideline after that catch. They're fired out. That's a big game.
Come on, man. They ain't letting none of my niggas act on the ball, bro. For real, for real.
Now a first down carry. It's Kamara.
Shit, weird.
It's been like this all night long. Nowhere to run as they stop it behind the line. That's going to wind up a loss of a full 3 yards on first down.
You talking about running the ball?
That loss of three, a rare stumble on a promising drive.
Oh, boy, you sleep, boy. You not just see this nigga just kill him? He just killed him. That was one time, though, out the whole game. That's why I gotta say respect.
Second and 13.
Get my son away.
That's to his right.
But this shit is crazy as fuck, Mo. Like, hey, bro, look. I don't know what else to do. I ain't even gonna hold, bro. I don't even know what else to do at this point, bro. Cause this shit is crazy, bro. You get a strip fumble. All these animated catches put you back.
That
was crazy.
They'll try to run it in with Murray. And he is
shit wild out here.
The line of scrimmage. They'll say no.
Shit is wild out here. I don't know why they doing this to me, bro. I can't get no. Like, this nigga is just throwing that bitch to all my quarters, bro. Everybody getting mossed off. I can't believe it. That just mean I feel bad for the next nigga I play. That's what Matt usually means.
Stay on the ground.
Come on, man.
And it's been like this all night long.
Stop him. Get, hey, look, he about to throw that bitch. He gonna throw a crazy ass pass, bruh. He gonna throw a crazy ass pass, bruh. We already see it. Hey, look, this shit is wild, bro. Like, what the fuck?
He's trying to force it in there on third down.
But man, is real deal out here today, bro. For no reason, bro. All my niggas getting their hands on the football. Les, you can't say we not, bro.
This one's still certainly a long ways from over.
It definitely puts a lot of pressure on the defense to hold the lead, right? They're happy to have it and happy to be out there trying to do it.
Me! Me, man, me. This is crazy. That's wild, bro. We gotta catch them, bro. That's pick.
And a tight game after punting last time. See if they can get something going on this drive.
This shit wild, bro. They don't want me to win. This game just seems determined, bro. This game seems pretty determined, bro. I ain't even gonna hold you. This game seems pretty determined, bro. I got Patty Mahomes, though. Anything's possible. Sam, you can't even touch the corner up, Sam. That's what you're telling me.
Would have been a first down if not for that penalty moments ago. 3 points separating these two sides with 2 minutes.
You can't even touch them up. Not even a tad bit. So the wild out here, bro. He was trying to make some shape, man. That's all, bro. Come up with offensively after having time to talk it over.
On second and 7, Mahomes forced out to his left. He'll hit Watkins on the
come on, block him. Good shit. Let's go, man. Damn. This I can't even sit back there and look at shit. This nigga Cameron Jordan crazy. Let's go, man. Patty Mahomes.
Wow. I know it's a never say never situation, but to me, that looks like that's the one that's going to finish him off.
The score that puts him in front here late, Bennett. You got to
come on, man.
Don't you say the last thing we need is a big return.
The craziest part, this nigga ain't even block you, bro. You just ran into him. You probably would have tackled me.
This is taking about 7 yards deep.
Let's go, man. Fuck. He got to score, bro. That's all he's saying, bro. Let's go, man.
The Saints offense on the field ready to get their drive started. And they had 3 points last time, but they didn't want 3 points because they were well within range of scoring a touchdown. We'll see if they can do better now.
I'm with you on that one. Let's just go ahead and be frank about the whole thing. The only one happy about the 3 points.
The kicker.
Exactly. He put it through the post. That's going to help him in contract time. But that offense, they're thinking, let's get in the end zone this time.
I don't know if that'll help him in contract time. You could have kicked that one through.
Get that out of there, man. Get that out of there. You messed that up. You definitely messed that up. You had a tutty, bro. Yeah, yeah. You pressed triangle. You pressed triangle.
I know as a defender, I'm loosening up a couple of extra steps that allowed him to run with him.
You pressed triangle. You should have pressed square. But then again, I probably would have picked that bitch because you threw a line drive. I don't know, bro. I had press squared. I ain't even hold you. Oh, fuck. God. Man, come. Good use of playmaker, bro. Nah, good use of playmaker, bro. Nah, good use of playmaker, bro. Good use of playmaker, bro. Good use of playmaker, bro. I can't even. Nah, I can't even be mad at you. Good use of playmaker. Yo, bro, this shit crazy. We sent you right there, bro.
A gain of 39 that time. But that's now two catches on
we sitting that nigga right there, bro.
The possibility of using video for coaching on the sidelines, that's not approved yet, but you can still use pictures. They got to send his picture down to their
defense. That's crazy as shit. That's some bullshit, bro. I sat that nigga right there, bro. We seen the wheel route, bro. But bro had to get killed.
These guys have fought all the way back to grab the lead, and I'll just tell people what happened when they went up 3 scores. I wrote on your paper 2 words: game over. And now I'm eating those.
We seen the wheel route, bro. This shit crazy. Right, come on, look, come on. You got a super
looked like it was going that way. This is one of those paging Frank Reich moments. I can't believe I just brought that up. Because Frank Reich, at Maryland in college, did it to my Tennessee Volunteers. And that was a big reason why my team lost.
Bro, I'm just trying to make
some pain from that game.
I'm just trying to make some
shit. We still got a little time to work it out with the doctor.
Remember
right to throw. He's got a first down and then some inside the 40. Now the Bears going to call the first of their timeouts as they stop it with 28 seconds to go in this football game. Back-to-back good plays have them on the move on first down.
Kill, kill, kill. Show it up. Show it up.
Yellow, yellow. Hero 15.
He's back to throw. And the pressure will get to him. He goes down. Now there is a flag on the play, but this looks like holding on the offense.
I need him and everything.
Now they
bro.
Face a second and long following the holding penalty.
On second down. Come on, man. You got jukebox for a reason, bro.
Continues. Now the Bears going to use the second of their timeouts as they stop it with 22 ticks to go in the fourth. Need something from deep in the bag of tricks here after first and second down went backwards. It's third and very long. Back to throw, Mahomes. This one into the hands of Burton. Now the Bears will use their third and final timeout. As the clock will stop with 18 seconds remaining. And his kick is good. And that will tie this game here in the final minute of play. So in the final minute, they turn it over to their kicker to get him back to even.
Yeah, he has jukebox disappointing.
Man, do you think the pressure ever gets to this guy? Because I sure don't. That was pretty smooth right there. But I tell you, he better not rest on his laurels. Because it's a good
But we can't get a hit. Bro, my shit say user hit stick, bro. I swear to God, that shit said user hit stick. And that is a weak ass hit. Look at that weak ass hit, bro. Why the fuck is they holding me, bro?
The Saints offense.
Why the fuck is they trying to hold me, bro?
They have a little bit of time here to get into field goal range. Not much. In a tie game, you don't want to do anything crazy, right?
I agree with you on that one. Risk reward, okay? If you go for it, what is the absolute reward on this? But the risk is probably greater. Run the clock out, get to overtime, and try and get it there.
All right, we'll see if they do just that. Going up top.
Man, he's supposed to go get that bit.
With a clock showing just 3 seconds left. He was trying to hit
square that bitch all the way up. Fuck that.
So after the incompletion, second and 10 for the 22.
Taking
the
OT shit crazy. Shit is belligerent.
Looking again for Thomas, this time complete. And we got free football.
Shit, crazy as fuck, man.
Dead even. We'll have overtime after this timeout.
Big ass. That was like a crazy ass 17-point swing, bro. Like, real dog.
That's exactly right. If they go down and kick a field goal. The other team gets a possession.
This is crazy. You posted a stream in the chat.
To win the ball game. If both teams kick field goals, the next team to score wins. But if the receiving team throws,
I ain't even look at that jump. You know, get the chat. This is wild, bro.
The game is over at that point.
They don't want me to win.
The Saints offense on the field, ready to get their drive started. Except for their first drive here in overtime. And this is where the crowd can really become a factor.
They've had to battle it all day, but I know what you're saying. In overtime, that gets double, doesn't it? At least, because now the crowd really wants to be involved and help their team. And that first drive can dictate the whole thing, because they know if this team takes it downfield and scores a touchdown, it's game over.
It's been loud in here so far.
Come on, man. We do for a turnover, bruh. That's all I'm saying.
Second and 9 from the 26.
We do for a fucking turnover.
first throw here in overtime.
Bro, I've been stopped pressing triangle.
The catch and run, good for 18 and a first down.
Hey, bro, I don't know what's up, bro. I swear to God, bro. This shit is the wig right now, bro.
Success.
That, and it means you really didn't miss opportunities. Usually very accurate. The ball's getting to the right place. Guys are making yardage.
I need these. Give me that, nigga. Thank you. Finally. Damn.
Inside the 10. And a big turnover there as his guys will get the
shit, man. I'm like, bro, we do for one, bro. Like, come on, bro.
Spotlight here in overtime of this game, a costly pick.
No doubt about that, but here's the key. Game's not over. He may very well get another shot at this thing, so now he's got to go to the sideline, hope his defense picks him up, and be ready to go back out there and maybe make a similar throw, hopefully successfully the next time.
First throw of overtime for Mahomes.
Passing come on, man.
We do have a penalty flag down, however. Let's see what that's about.
God damn. That's crazy as a bitch.
She
did that goofy
like they were able to exploit right there.
6 yards on that last play. Here's second and four. What can Mahomes do now with his overtime?
This nigga sent the house. Literally.
He goes down. Oh, free safety blitz, that can be a gamble, but it proves fruitful there.
Yeah, you're exactly right about the gamble, because oftentimes the free safety is the last line of defense against a long pass, and when he comes at the quarterback, he better get home and make the play. Otherwise, a big play could result for the offense.
2 minutes left in this overtime session, and still all tied.
This nigga just brought the house and I have
to touch down. Third down, an extra defensive back on the field.
And he did not get the ball up. Give a fuck.
Shotgun snap to Mahomes. And this is Gabriel on the catch. And he'll be brought down at the 28, and that is well short of the first. The completion good for only 6, and that'll bring up 4.
Charged.
Here's Pat O'Donnell now, on for a very important punt here in overtime.
Oh, my God!
And he couldn't get it to check up. That kicks all the way into the end zone.
Yo, this shit is the ultimate wig, bruh.
The Saints offense on the field ready to get their drive started.
We had our chance. That was good. That was good pick. We had our chance.
A little bit more cautious when you start that next drive, or don't you just throw that out the window?
I think you are. I don't think that there's any way you can run back out there.
Ooh!
Still catching our breaths from that electric finish. You get an overtime, that's one thing. It was a great score. But then an OT, not only to win it, but to win it on a defensive score.
Wow. Oh.
On, we're going to definitely travel someone who could help us, because I thought I was going to pass out at the end. Not just getting to the overtime, but the plays in overtime that led to this one, and to finish it on a defensive touchdown, a takeaway that gets into the end zone. I'm not rooting for anyone, but boy, I'd love to see games finish that way.
So for Chicago, their strong start to the year continues as they're up to 5-1, and they'll get to stay home again next week. Meanwhile, for the Saints, the loss will drop them to 4-2 on the year. And they'll get a chance to redeem themselves at home next week. So for our entire crew, alongside Charles Davis, I'm Brandon Gauden. Thanks for watching, everybody. We'll see you next time.
Jeez, bro. That was a crazy game, bro. That nigga Patty Fado, he don't fold. Innocent.
Now let's take a minute to see how you can improve your team.